sponsor, says, "Hey, you know that this is cool. Come on, find me a young fellow named Billy Crocker. He's got my passport."
Mr. Whitney?
What?
Could we have a picture of you, please?
It's Elisha J. Whitney. You know, Wall Street.
Camera, give it to Mr. Whitney. Who's next, Charlie? Get him. I'm trying to wax.
Sir Oakley, you and Miss Harcourt, right?
Whoa.
Picture, society stuff.
What are their names?
Sir, what is your first name?
Evelyn.
Not your first name.
I repeat, my name is Evelyn. My fiance's name is Miss Harcourt.
Get a good photo shot. They're saying we can be married on the other side.
Is this from his dad?
I hope you can, Larry Bolton. Which one's the bride?
This is Mrs. Harcourt.
Oh, please, feel free to call me Mother.
Right, your mother.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Harcourt, but we want a picture of the happy couple.
And this, look at me. I see.
Listen, Edith, put your arm around her.
I'm afraid this is the best we can do.
Fight.
Okay, we'll just step to one side. Who are what?
Hey, this is a bishop and a couple of his Christians.
Nobody would print that stuff. Get us a damn.
Hey, girls! You want to get your picture in the paper?
Yeah!
Get it there. Hey, a bitch, give me a little dope on yourself, huh?
My name is Bishop Henry T. Dobson, D.C., Ph.D., LL.D. Moderator of the Chinese Anglican Church. President Emeritus of the Foreign Missionary Society of the World. Honorary Chaplain of the Army of the Chinese Republic.
Two swell stories for our Chinese edition, huh? How about my photograph?
Hey, it's Reno Sweetie and the Four Angels!
Reno Sweetie? No, are they sailing?
Well, they ain't planning to swim.
Reno Sweetie?
Who was it they're making such a fuss about? Reno Sweetie, the famous knight. And he's got a Four Angels. All that former evangelist. There's no longer anything exclusive about an Atlantic crossing.
How do you do?
Say hello, girl.
best offer I've heard since I've been unemployed.
How long will it take to pass?
Well, there's my other shirt.
You'll be great. Sing, dance, Billy. You're my new master of ceremonies.
Oh, Reno, I don't think so.
Why not? I think you'd be marvelous.
Well, you're the one who has all the talent. You're beautiful, smart, sexy.
True, tell me more.
I'm running out of words that do you justice.
My words poetic are so pathetic that I always have found it best instead of getting them off my chest to let them rest. Unexpressed, I hate parading my serenade as I'll probably miss a ball.
Billy, I have something to explain.
Oh dear!
Oh dear!
My fiance. We're sailing to be married.
Your fiance?
Yes.
You're sailing to be married?
Yes.
Then I'm sailing too.
We'll be meeting again then.
Oh, again and again and again.
All ashore, going ashore. All ashore, going ashore. Oh, Billy, that was not pleasant.
Reno, I'm sailing.
So I see.
None of the hall matters, though. I haven't a ticket, money, or a cabin.
Well, there's my house.
I don't have any clothing.
I could lend you a nightgown.
Thanks. Well, there's a man I need to see. Purser, come to work with you, please.
Excuse me. There are a couple of FBI men waiting for me at the end of the gangway.
FBI?
What's happening, Purser?
Well, a couple of gangsters are supposed to be on board. FBI thinks you're trying to get out of the country on this ship. And I understand one of them is dressed up like a preacher.
Preacher? Well, say, I've seen that guy. Just a minute. Well, come on, I'll show you.
Why I couldn't have been a cowboy or an Indian.
Now, Mooney, you look great in that preacher suit. I'd hardly even recognize you myself. You just keep your head and we'll make a clean getaway. I'll put my snake eyes on
you. Doctor, may I present myself? I am Bishop Henry T. Dobson.
Hiya, Bish.
Are you attending the conference?
The conference? No, I thought I'd go to bed early tonight.
I mean the Westminster Conference.
Oh, the Westminster Conference. well, no, you see, I'm not really a Westminster. I'm really more from the East.
I see you play the violin, Doctor.
Yeah, but only on special occasions, like St. Valentine's Day.
What is your field?
Oh, well, I'm a sort of a, sort of missionary.
Missionary? Where?
Way out in China.
China?
Way out in China.
I've served in China for years.
Oh, well, you see, I wasn't exactly in China now. I was more in the...
I see, you were in Indochina.
That's it. I was in indoor China. And you was in outdoor China.
We'll have lots to discuss. I'll see you later. Oh, hola, Jinja. Arigato.
Yeah, I don't know, but I think it's downstairs.
Bonnie!
Bonnie, I'm in trouble already!
Have the cops been yet?
What cops?
There are a couple on board and they're looking for you and Snake Eyes.
How do you know?
I've been trailing them. They told the captain is looking for tonight except with a preacher.
Oh, you better take the violin. Where can I hide?
Stay away from your captain.
Why?
They're watching that. I know. Mix with the passengers. Get into a group.
What?
Get into a group of passengers. I'll find you later.
Wait a minute, Bonnie.
Your mother?
That reminds me. I must admit, to Elias. Yes, always keep in touch with Mater. She's a man's best friend.
Mater's been horribly upset with all this delay.
Oh, don't worry, Evelyn. I run to her about hopes for health.
You know, you never appreciate good health until you lose it.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, I used to have palpitations in the Pope and cramps in the crypt.
Now let's go on board the front of the ship.
Yes, Lex, that's a great idea. Say it.
Doctor, do you mind converting someone else?
What did he look like? How tall was he?
Probably just about as tall as you. There he is.
Seize that man! Come on, Moonface, you're not sailing on this ship.
Help! What is waiting for? I'm here to get up. Help!
Sailors! Tell it to the FBI.
Bon voyage.
You mean bon voyage?
Here
we go.
from some people I didn't want to see.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I can't say goodbye to myself. I couldn't say goodbye to a girl. Now I'm in a hell of a mess. Oh, pardon me, Doc.
Oh, I don't give a damn. Hey, you did me a favor, Bob. Maybe I can do you one.
I don't think so, Doc. Your problem isn't spiritual, it's financial.
Oh, well, if it's money you want, I can get you some of that.
You can?
Sure. I mean, the guy who's sailing with me's got about 50 grand on it. Very easy going with it, too, which is natural. Time was when he used to make the stuff himself.
Money!
Oh, Bonnie, what did you see, Snake Eye? I mean, did you see Mr. Hill?
Well, that's what I came to tell you about.
What, did the cops get him? I mean, was he a forcibly retained?
Well, I don't know about that. He just never showed up. And he left me holding this ticket.
Say, is that a ticket? Well, that's just as good as money.
Well, hey, if it's a ticket you want, here, be my guest.
Well, thanks. Here, yeah, Reverend.
And, how about his passport? Could you use this too?
God help me if they look at this picture.
We can fix you so you resemble it. Let's see, give you a little scar right here. Part your head differently, and, then I can break your nose.
Let's not be hasty.
Well, I can break it slowly.
Fix me up.
What?
Fix me up!
Oh! Excuse me. This is Barney. I think you two want to get acquainted with it. I mean, after all, you are going to be roommates.
Roommates?
Yeah, she goes with Mr. Hill's ticket.
That's okay. I've got other engagements. If it's all right with you, Doc, can I bunk in with you?
Sure.
Thanks. Goodbye.
Hey, Mooney. It's gonna be awful lonesome in that big cabin. All by myself.
Now, Barney, you gotta go and bring sex into this. I mean, it's bad enough me being a minister.
Isn't it beautiful?
A bit overdone, I should say.
And the moon is overdone too, I suppose.
No, it's all right for what it is. But I've never shared the general enthusiasm for the moon.
Evening, here we are on the deck of a ship, in the moonlight. Doesn't that mean anything to you?
Sorry, old dear, but until I get my sea legs, I'm afraid I just can't rise to it. All the little things about sailors.
Oh, hello there. I hope I'm intruding.
No, not a bit. As a matter of fact, about the call of the night.
Oh, I call the night.
As far as I can see, there's only one thing wrong with it.
Yes, I was just saying, there's a bit of a hole. I don't like being talked about.
Oh, you'll be all right once we get past the terrace. That's from the place on the coast, you know.
How soon do we get there?
You'll know it with me, too.
Whoa.
Whoa.
You won't feel that roll.
It's starting.
Well, I think I should go downstairs and prepare myself for death. Oh, my goodness. And you hope.
Oh, it's getting worse.
Oh,
there it goes.
Oh, and here I am. Oh, my goodness.
Is that fair?
Fair? I see you standing in the moonlight with him. I didn't shoot him and push him overboard. You said it was more than fair.
Billy, you've got to stop. We met one night. One single night. At a party. We danced. We had a little too much wine. We took a little spin around the park.
A little spin? A little spin? You call 12 hours in the back of a taxi a little spin.
9 hours.
12. Back with you and three more trying to borrow enough money to pay off the bug of the driver.
Well, I spent 3 hours trying to explain to Mother, and you were much help.
I thought it was very nice to your mother.
Nice? Telling her you were George Bernard Shaw.
I want her to think you were in St. Anne's.
Well, she wasn't amused. You'd better stay out of her way on this trip, Billy. She hasn't forgotten or forgiven you for that night.
I see you've forgotten. What's all this nonsense about a fiancé?
It isn't nonsense. Sir Ethan and I have been engaged for a long time. Except for 9 hours. Well,
as far as I'm concerned, it's off again. And the seagull we have is a big improvement over a taxi cab. You see? Even the moon's doing better by us.
It's getting late, Ellen. I've got a call tonight.
Don't go yet, please. Just 5 more minutes. And just a quick spin around the deck.
I remember what happened the last time.
Hope, here we are on the deck of the ship. In the moonlight. Does that mean anything to you?
The night is young, the sky is clear, and if you'd like to go walking, dear, it's divine, for it's delicious, it's lovely. I understand the reason why you're sentimental, so am I. It's divine, for it's delicious, it's lovely. You can tell that I can't, but
thank you.
Yes. Can you tell me what room Mr. Elijah J. Whitney is in? Yes, Whitney. 76M? Thank you.
Hey, here you are. The corridor is full of them.
Doc, we've got to change our cabin.
Why? I like it here. It's, very cozy.
My boss is in the next cabin.
What, you mean that gray-haired man with the short-sighted glasses?
He thinks I'm back on Wall Street.
He sees me on this ship. Well, hey, I prepared your shoes for you, didn't I? Maybe I can do something with this, like, swipe his glasses.
Doc, I don't know what religion you exactly belong to, but, brother, you're a Christian.
Oh, we men of the cloth have our frivolous moments.
Stuart! Stuart!
Glasses. Pardon me, brother, but were you calling for a steward?
I thought I made that clear to everyone else on this boat.
Oh, well, I sent her down in the corner for something. She'll be right back.
Hey,
why not wait in here?
If I don't get up on deck in a minute, it won't do me a bit of good. The motion of this boat is starting to get to me.
Oh, seasick, eh? Well, why don't you take off your glasses?
I ought to do nothing of the kind. I'm in no mood for anything cute. I may need you later, but for now, I'd rather suffer alone.
Well, if you need anything, just let me know.
What the hell is in this room? A flying fish?
No, a bat. Shoot, shoot. Go away, and don't come back.
Will you get off my bed and out of my room? You're making me nervous.
Okay, but would you mind helping me down first? I'm afraid of heights.
Where the hell are my glasses?
I see them. Just a second. I'll get them for you. Oh. Well, it kind of looks like you're going to have to put on your other pair.
I don't have another pair.
Good. That's what I wanted to know. Well, I took care of his glasses. And he hasn't got another pair.
Great.
Now come in.
Oh, good morning, Mooney, Billy.
Hiya, Bonnie. Doc, I gotta see a man about getting a new suit. Excuse me.
Yeah, did you have a good night?
Not bad at all. That's the cutest sailor. You know, I feel safer out here in the ocean if I've got a sailor handy.
Now, who is it?
That person.
Just a second. I'm not decent yet. Come in.
Sorry to disturb you, Doctor, but does a James Hill occupy this cabin?
Not very often. Why, is anything wrong?
Well, I feel I should warn you. We've had a radio burn from Washington. Seems he's not James Hill. He's Snake Eyes Johnson, public enemy number one.
You're kidding!
No! They arrested one of his Confederates just before we sailed. If he does return, come up again. And if you can't make it, send the little girl underneath the covers.
Gee! What if they grab Billy for Snake Eyes? He'd have to take the rap!
We can't let that happen. I mean, I kind of like the guy. Besides, I think he has some kind of a racket going. I mean, he stayed out all night.
Oh, Mooney, he's just an old softy.
Here I am.
Yeah, and I'm glad you are.
All set for the trip.
Listen, mister, I'm afraid we're in a hell of a jam.
I'm doctor. I'll have to tell your bishop on you.
Well, we might as well start with the bishop. You see, I'm not really a clergyman. I'm a moon-faced martyr. I'm a crook. Hey, I'm wanted in America.
Nonsense, Doc. What about another crook in America?
You don't realize who he is. Moon-faced is public enemy number 13.
Now, Bonnie, we don't have to go on mention.
Now, Mooney, I told you. You're going to work up. Maybe help you with the news comes out.
isn't that
the time?
Will you listen to me?
Some other time, Bob. Some other time.
Make him listen, Mooney. Make him listen.
Okay. Now, you listen to me or I'll blow your head off.
Hey, what the hell you got there?
This is my old pal. Putt, putt, putt.
Well, putt, putt, putt it away, will you? I'm not going to turn you in. You're my pal.
That's what I've been trying to tell you. That ticket and passport I gave you, they belong to Public Enemy Number One.
Public Enemy Number One?
Public Enemy Number One!
What, is there an echo in here?
You mean that ugly-looking guy in the passport picture?
Don't you go running down Snake Eyes Johnson!
Snake Eyes Johnson?
Are we gonna hide you someplace?
I can't hide! My girl's waiting for me up on deck!
But the purser is looking for you! Of course, I could, kill the purser.
Oh, rust up, Doc. What will they do to me if they get me?
Oh, well, there's kind of been some talk of electrocuting Snake Eyes.
Oh, well, that's great.
But they'll go right through the passage until they find you.
Yeah? But they wouldn't think of looking to the crew.
Hey, now that's an idea.
What? Can you give me a sailor's suit?
Sure, I can get you a sailor's suit. He's still asleep.
Say, where's your
buy him a drink. He probably needs it.
Poor devil. Hiya, kid.
Say, come back here! How dare you?
Ta-ta.
What on earth are you doing in those clothes?
I joined the Navy.
See the world, I suppose.
No, see you.
You didn't have any difficulty last night.
And tonight's going to be even easier.
I found a place on the ship even the captain doesn't know about. I have a lot of things to say to you.
For instance.
Well, I love you. Did I say anything about that last night?
I think the subject came up.
And I'm going to marry you? Did I mention that?
Yes. But let me remind you, I'm still happily engaged.
Sailor! What are you doing down here? Follow me.
Aye, aye, sir. You see, I even display orders for you.
I hope you're enjoying your trip, Mrs. Harcourt.
I've never been so bored in my entire life.
Mrs. Harcourt, now we're making 24 knots.
I'm not interested in rope tricks. This is the dullest passenger list I've ever seen. No one of importance, no celebrities on board.
There's Reno Sweeney.
She's not famous. She's notorious.
Some like them better that way.
Hello. I'm Ethan.
Hello.
Are you taking news about the Battle of Rome?
my sabbatical. That is Reno Sweeney.
Ooh, not the Reno Sweeney. Give me an intro, Josh, will you?
Oh, Reno, what? Mrs. Sweeney, I'd like you to meet him.
My name's Evelyn Oakley. I'm delighted to know you, Miss Sweeney. I spent an evening at your nightclub once. Quite eventful. As a matter of fact, it's the day I proposed to my fiancé.
You mean proposition?
Is that what you Americans call it?
If it's in my nightclub, it's a proposition.
Well, I had quite an evening. Your singing seemed to stir me. Since my pulse was racing, I turned to Miss Harcourt. Right there, I propositioned her. See here, Miss Harcourt, I said, why don't we get married in a year or two?
Hey, I think you better give him his money back.
She'll be so delighted to know I've met you. Shall I try and find her?
Please do.
Ooh. Well, I say, come we'll have cocktails together in my cabin at 1 o'clock.
I love it.
Oh, my goodness. Well, I'll go find Miss Harcourt and let you know. Oh, this is exciting. Oh, dear. Oh, my. Oh. Oh, dear, dear, my. Oh, dear.
Bye. Hey, you were doing great, Reno. You kept them out of Billy's hand for nearly a minute.
Never mind.
Yeah, but you can't do anything in front of his girlfriend. He's a crowd, you know.
Now, these Englishmen have high volumes.
Yeah, that's true, too. Hey, then let's bring. Yeah, can't you ever dress that slips off easily? I'll bust in and accuse him of tearing your clothes off, and then I'll blackmail him into breaking off the engagement.
Get you behind me, Lupe. I kind of like you guys. He's different.
Yeah, but Rio, you promised Billy.
Now, almost persuaded me. Shoot the works. You know, if you weren't a friend of Billy's, I'd unprop you.
Now, Reno, there's a time and a place for everything.
Hey, you know what?
What?
We didn't find me.
Hey. I bet you'll be here, Billy. I've got a date.
That's great.
He talks too. What's he good for?
Oh, he doesn't work, Reno. He's a gentleman.
That gentleman's just a bad thing. Maybe I could jump.
Oh, that'd be great. If you can keep away from home until we get to England, and the doc here can keep the fruits out of my hair, I've got it made.
Yeah, you can count on me.
Who is it, Billy? Through thick office.
Night or day.
Why, you're wrong.
If you're ever in a town, here I am.
If you're ever in a mess, S.O.S.
If you ever
bags to hang over the side, and steward, make it snappy.
ma'am.
Yes, well, sir.
Thank you. Come the darling, why can't they I say them? Sing, sing, sing. Come the darling, oh, come in. Come the darling. Oh, just put it down on the bed. I hope it's good and hot. You know, I did so want it before I started to dress.
Say, am I only all late? Ooh.
Well, I thought it was the steward with my team, but I'm delighted that you. We've oodles of time before dinner, and I did so want to have a chat with you.
Well, I'm certainly glad you feel that way about me, because I certainly feel that way about you.
What way?
Lovely.
Oh, no. You know, I love the expression you Americans use. I'm making a collection of them. Just a moment. To feel that way about a person means to rub his neck. You don't get us.
You don't understand what I mean. You sent it.
I sent it to you.
Oh, damn it, Evie, you know what I mean. Well, look at you and I get hot pants.
Do you really? What a bit of ice to any good.
No, Evie. That means I like
it. It means you like me. Hot pants. Why not write this down? How perfectly polished.
I don't think that means true.
Yes.
Look, you're a man. I'm a woman. Man, woman, you, me.
Quite. But what does that have to do with us?
A hell of a lot. Evie, you excite me.
I excite you? Well, now this is exciting.
What's going on here? So this is what I find.
You beast! Despoiler of innocent girlhood! Just look at this poor child! Her clothes torn off by your fiendish attack, standing there in her name! Get next. There's something wrong here.
There's nothing wrong here. Look, Reese, everything's strictly on up and up.
Wait a minute, I'll be right back. Aha!
What's going on here?
You beast! You stand there in your nakedness! Your clothes torn off in a fiendish attack on this innocent child!
Wait a minute, you
beast! No! Stand back!
I'll not permit this British lion to twist American womanhood by that tail! And do you think your girlfriend will marry you after this? And don't think she won't know because I'm gonna tell her!
Oh, do tell her! Only make it a bit thicker. She's always complaining that I lack fervor.
Hey, you don't get the idea.
Be sure to call me a beast, won't you? I rather like that one. You don't mind me, sweetie.
A beast?
Well, wait a minute.
Yeah, wait a minute. You're not taking the right attitude. You should get scared. Go on. Get frightened. This is a serious business. I happen to be a dangerous man.
Come, come, Padre. You're an old dear and you know it.
There's something wrong here. I'm gonna prove to you that I'm a desperate character. Now, do you mind waiting a minute? Okay, now wait right here. I won't be long.
I say, you know what's wrong with the little fellow?
Listen, Evie. I'll give the lowdown, even if I have to take the rap myself. He was sent to bust in to catch us in a clinch, and you didn't clinch that far.
Oh, do you mean he thought I'd make love to you?
That was my idea when I came in here.
Oh, well, this is exciting. Oh, my gosh.
What's going on here?
Now I guess you realize just how serious of a business this is.
Hey, what are you trying to pull? Put the gun down.
No.
Put the gun down.
It's all right, Padre. You thought I would take advantage of Miss Sweeney, and you came to her rescue. Glad I am for that, Padre. I wish I could tell you how much I admire you. I know. I have hot pants for you.
Hey, keep away from me or I'll shoot!
Oh,
Bishop. They're waiting for that order in the bar.
I need a civilian coat. Civilian coat. Man overboard! Man overboard! There, go on and save it. You can do it. Hey, here you are. Find something to cover up that face.
If only had a beard.
A beard.
Oh, wait. Can I talk with you a minute?
Oh, certainly, sir. I have seen you on deck, and I'd rather hope that we might have acquainted. You see, I recently organized a home for wayward girls.
Hey, I might have known a couple of them. Well, I'll try me with a name or two. Now that's one business that just keeps on booming.
I've enjoyed a little talk, Doctor. Now I must go find my doctor. I'll be seeing you.
I'm afraid so. Yeah, that reminds me. I gotta buy a box of cough drops.
But, Mother, it's ridiculous chasing around this boat this way. You may not mean anything to you at all.
But if the captain wants to...
Is this not a Mrs. Haircut?
Harcourt! Mrs. Wadsworth T. Harcourt!
Well, Charles! I was born to introduce myself to you by my dear cousin, the Duke of Hanover.
The Duke of Hanover! I met him in Paris.
Oh, yes. The French have been so kind to my poor exiled family since the revolution.
Really? You have to take your hat off to the French.
Oh, that's not why you take up. Oh, now that we're acquainted, we must become, buddies. You and your beautiful sister.
Oh, this is not my sister. My daughter.
Your daughter? It is not possible.
Oh, I want you to meet this gentleman. This is my daughter, Miss Harcourt.
How do you do? I am Signor Arturo Moreno Antonio. Grazie. Oh, but you may call me Your Excellency.
Oh, I'll leave you two together while I go and find the captain. Au revoir. Tout de l'eau. A bientôt.
Nice woman, your grandmother.
Yes, mother's very nice.
She was nice indeed to leave us together. Oh, the time it was you. You assume my wish makes speak. But I see you guessed my little secret. I am not Signora Arturo Antonio Moreno Grazia. No, I'm George Bernard Shaw. I've got a beard to prove it.
You idiot.
Oh, Count, I'm very glad to ask you if you'd like to join us for cocktails.
Cocktails? Cocktails? I was not going to join you for cocktails.
Tell me, are you French or Spanish?
Many different things.
Hey, old bar. Hey, I'll see you girls later, okay?
Doctor, there you are. I've been looking for you. It seems you're in a bit of trouble.
Oh, I knew I couldn't get away with it. It's about those two converts. Hey, don't tell me those two nice girls are converts.
No. You're Chinese converts.
Oh, my Chinese converts, of course.
They don't allow gambling on the third class. You must make them understand that, or we'll have to lock them up. I've sent for them, and I'm going to leave them in your care. Here they are, sir.
Can young folk be hung out? Do you mind? I think I'd better speak to these boys alone.
We'll leave everything to you.
Where's Bishop?
Oh, the fish stepped out for a few minutes. Is there anything that I can do for you boys?
Oh, well, they lost Captain. Spoiled games.
voice of Aunt Dan. Hey, don't you know you shouldn't gamble? I mean, not only is it sinful, but if you don't know how to deal off the bottom, you end up losing all your money.
Oh, we win. Get it all.
You bet $300? There's a little game that I'd like to show you boys. Kneel, Christian. Okay, now, I got $50. I put up my 50, and you put up your, 300. Let's just make it even. Now, I throw a number. If I throw the same number before I throw a 7, I win. If not, you win.
And both is a miracle.
This is the legend of love, and no one.
moved up into the suite deluxe. He's just brushing up a bit.
Oh, I'm so glad I decided to take this boat.
Oh, no, no, please. No more autographs.
I hope you're comfortable in your quarters, Mr. Dodson.
It's only two rooms and a bath, and if that's all you have, it'll have to do.
Well, if there's anything else, you just let me know.
Oh, thank you, Captain. I'll remember that.
How would you like to give us a little informal talk on jail if I have known Mr. Johnson? Why do they call you Snake Eyes, Mr. Johnson? Is it true that Japan does not dare attack America as long as you're alive?
How the hell? What are you trying to pull?
Aren't you proud of yourself, Mr. Johnson?
You can call me Snake Eyes.
Bill, this goes beyond
me. I've had this much fun since I was a kid.
So you call a spy that was one of the worst criminals who ever lived?
You're not hurting anyone.
It's hurting my respect.
For me? What about your respect for these damn fools who make a hero out of
me? I never had any respect for them. It's you, Billy, you can stop them if you want to.
All right, I'll make them lay off this hero worship. I won't have anything more to do with it.
Do you mean it, Billy?
I promise.
Oh, Mr. Jackson, we're waiting for you.
That's okay, you come on without me.
We can't. You've got to crown the Emperor first.
But I was just trying to...
Well, of course, my dear. You know that a castle is not the honeymoon cottage made.
England.
Oh, I'm there. Have you seen the moon?
No, I haven't.
Well, you must go take a look at it. It's most inspiring.
So, you found your sea legs. Say, was that a crack pie?
I'm sure she meant no offense.
And for your great step on deck, I bet you'd be hell of a sex.
You know, tonight for the first time, I understood why they speak so highly of the moonlight.
You know, things worked out. I'm me. Would you want to get together?
Get together? You mean become engaged?
That could do for me.
But I've never pictured you as the one-man type.
Neither have I until now.
But at least 20 men a year proposed to you. Bankers, and movie stars, and big politicians.
And not one of them stirs my pulse. I like a man with black.
Mr. Johnson's been telling us what you've been doing for him.
Oh, well, how much did he tell us?
No, listen, Knight. You're gonna reform and take care of the service?
Oh, which one? The army or the navy?
The religious service.
Oh, me?
It's a cinch, Mooney. Just follow me.
If anything goes wrong, I'll be there for you.
Here are the ship's songbooks, Doctor.
Can anyone open?
Bring your hand, Doctor.
Brethren and sister, friends, relatives, members of the DAR, the PTA, and the WPA. We are gathered here to try to reform Snake Eyes Johnson, who stands over there a repentant sinner. Good enough for my father, and it's good enough for me.
Right!
Now, won't you just look at that poor sinner over there, standing over there at war with his conscience, unable to find peace? Now I ask you, do we want war?
No!
Do we want peace?
No!
And what do we want?
Hooray!
And yet, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hollow that man. It is rather we should ask ourselves if he who throws the first stone wants to live in a glass house.
Right!
For neither rain nor storm nor dark of night will deter these stone throwers from their appointed throwing rounds.
Yeah!
In other words, be kind to your friends, because if it wasn't for them, it'd be a total stranger. And in the words of the late Warden Lewis E. Laws, there is no such thing as a bad criminal, only bad parents.
Yeah!
And as the warden said to me, you're only in here for 1 to 5, so keep
wait,
your nose.
Wait a minute. Brother, sister, I get the call. We're here to fight the devil.
Yeah!
I'm going to lead that fight.
Yeah!
I want everyone to turn to their neighbor and say, bless you, brother, bless you, sister.
Bless you, brother, bless you, sister.
There's only one way to fight the devil, and that's in the open.
Yeah!
I confess, there was a time that I drank.
Ooh.
Sit down, you will sit a chance.
I'm just cursing that feels that for my problem. She's not confessing, she's advertising. Come on, get busy. I want a real confession. You can tell me. I know what sin is. I confess.
I'll confess. I once let it go astray.
Hey, now that's more like it. Can't we hear from another layman?
Two?
Do I hear
three? Three!
Hey, sold to the man with the bloodshot eyes. May I say a word?
Yes, brother. Please do.
I've never played this game before, but I'm rather enjoying it, and I would like to add my bit. I may not be able to convince these gentlemen in point of number, but I may land in touch of color. When I was visiting China some time ago, I met a young Chinese girl named Plum Blossom, of whom I became very fond. Well, we eventually had an unpremeditated romp in the rice plantation, and very much thank you.
I was worried about you, brother, but I feel much better now.
Is there anyone? Would you mind repeating what you just said for us, please?
It's your turn, Mr. Johnson. After all, this is all being done for you.
Yes, Mr. Johnson. We all know there have been a great many women in your life. Yeah, go ahead, kid. You can top all these guys.
Yes, brother. Get right into yourself.
Yes, speak up, Mr. Johnson.
You're among friends.
Yes, Mr. Johnson. They want a confession. Why don't you give them a real one? This is your chance to tell them the truth. Please.
All right. You want a confession? I'll give you a confession. But first, I have something to say. There's one confession I haven't heard tonight. I haven't heard any one of you say that you're ashamed to know me, public enemy number one. You're proud to know me. You're
probably be on the same ship with me. You fight to shake my hand. And why?
Because I'm a celebrity? What kind of a celebrity? The biggest murderer in the world. Well, the joke's on you, 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 and you. I'm not public enemy number one. I'm not Snake Eyes Johnson. The name is William C. Crocker. Broken down, broken.
Mr. Bartlett, throw this imposter in the brig.
Billy.
You're under arrest. What for? For stealing a first call ticket and passport.
Hey, if you girls want a real public enemy to hide lies, I happen to be Moonface Mark, public enemy number 13.
And you're going with it?
Hey, wait a minute, there's something wrong.
Hey,
Bobby!
Hey.
Now there's a lesson for you, sinners. Send your heart sign off the sink and tune in with him. Why will you stand on the third floor?
Now don't tell me what it is.
Half past what?
Oh, I don't know. I lost a little hand. I wonder what day it is.
It's Friday. We're in court.
Oh, we are?
And while you're there, take a good look at England. That's all we're going to see of it.
Oh, is that what that is? Looks like a dull day in yonder.
My business, terrible stuff. It's the one that I got out of my mind.
Hey, this ain't bad. Hey, were you ever in jail in Cicero?
Oh, I don't mean the new jail. I mean the old one.
Spare me the trouble, Inches, Doc, will you?
Hey, I've been in a lot of tough blue scowls. But down in Fayetteville, Arkansas, they've got just about as nice a little jail as I ever did see.
Please, Doc.
Hey, I was just trying to keep your mind on something pleasant. I knew you were thinking about her.
It's all I ever think about. Day and night. I even dream about her.
Oh.
Little heavy in here.
Oh, stop it, Doc. You're breaking my heart.
Hey,
Maybe we're looking too much on the dark side. Let's try to find a silver light. Remember, it's always darkest just before they turn the lights on.
There's that old Australian bush song that Melba used to sing. A song that always cheered me when I was blue. One even Melba said this bush song was a devilish song to sing. So be quiet whilst I render it for you. When your instinct tells you that it's faster, it's approaching you faster and faster. Just be like the bluebird and sing tweet tweet, tra la 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 la. When you know you're headed for the jail, don't allow me to face the moon. Be like the bluebird who never is blue, for he knows from his upbringing what singing can do. And though by other birds in the boughs he may expect that his efforts are perfectly lousy, he sings on and on.
Doc, did you hear that? She loves me.
Yeah, that's nice.
I gotta find a way to get up there and stop that marriage.
Yeah, but how are we gonna get out of here?
Well, they're getting out in a couple of hours. Excuse me. Would you gentlemen mind standing, please? He said stand up. Hey, mine fits. Try yours.
Hey, the coat looks all right, but I'm afraid the pants will choke me. Hey, I got an idea. Do you boys want to play a little poker?
No money.
Money? Oh, well, no need money. This is a strip poker.
Yeah.
Instead of money, you bet something you're wearing. Do you boys want to play draw?
Oh, we play
draw well.
Hey, good. Then we'll play stud. Okay. Let's see. Okay, first of all, you shuffle the cards thoroughly. Okay, now the idea is to get two cards down so that nobody can see what they are. Oh, everything is fine in here, thank you. Okay, let's see. Billy, you're high. What do you bet?
I bet my coat.
Do you say coat?
I say coat.
You say coat.
I say coat.
I say coat.
We all say coat.
Okay, now, you continue dealing, and the idea is to get a two of a kind,
or a pair,
three of a kind, four of a kind, five of a kind.
Oh.
You're high, what do you bet?
I bet pants.
Do you call pants?
I call pants.
You call pants.
I call pants.
Calling off pants, calling off pants, calling off pants.
I miss the before?
Yes. You see, I'm about to be married shortly.
Lots of hope.
I'm afraid so.
But I thought she...
I thought so too. I must admit, I was rather upset by it all at first. But then I met you, and I wasn't upset in the least.
And now?
It would appear I was mistaken. Hope doesn't love Billy. She loves me.
How do you know?
Well, the other day, Mrs. Parker informed me that Hope wants to be married right here on the shipboard.
She's crazy!
I'm afraid I have no choice but to carry out my obligation.
Why don't you just tilt
it? I can't do that. I'm committed. And it would scarcely be the gentlemanly thing to do.
The hell with me, gentlemen. I want you to be.
But I would despise myself. And you wouldn't respect me either.
Respect has never kept a girl warm on a cold night. Look, you do love me, don't you? I mean, I'd like to know before I go ahead and make the wrong decision.
Yes, I'm afraid I do have a soft fantasy.
Not exactly the same thing, but it will do. Listen, when the captain says, speak now, I'll forever hold your peace, you may hear a familiar voice.
Reno?
That's the name that goes with a familiar voice.
Reno!
Reno, will I ever see you again?
Sooner than you think!
Oh, Evelyn! There you are!
Oh, it's just an odd friend, Evelyn. You're sure you can handle the ceremony?
Well, it will be my first go at a marriage, but I've had a lot of experience. Well, with funerals. So it shouldn't be too difficult.
Evelyn, are you ready?
I suppose so, Mother.
Then I'll go find some blushing bride and we may begin. Don't run away.
She let it do it.
I am by
it out. I'll give you the 1,000 pounds to clear out of here.
And pounds of what?
That's money. $5,000.
We'll take it.
I'll make it 2,000.
Angus Dumbledore to come out and buy a Chinese honor.
Well, I'll make it 5,000.
Chinese honor sold.
No, Evelyn, don't take it. No amount of money can settle this great wrong. You, sir.
English ladies speak to me.
You are a relative of little Tonga.
Oh, so, but it goes with you.
Then the only way to pay this debt of honor, Evelyn, is for you to offer him me.
Marvelous idea.
Well.
Congratulations, old boy. You're getting quite good. Why not English gentlemen right wrong come to Mufasa?
Right wrong?
Join the club, kiddo.
Join the club? Well, I say, confounded, kid.
Ooh, Reno. Will you marry me?
I thought you'd never ask.
Boss?
Billy? What are you doing here?
How was your trip?
It was terrible. I lost my glasses. I've been blind for the last 5 days.
So I heard.
What about the amalgamation?
Oh, you didn't want anything to do with that.
I
flew over to tell you that I landed 2 new accounts. The Oakley interest and the hardcore account. This is Mrs. Hardcore. This is my boss, Mr. Elijah J. Whitney. You know Wall Street.
Did you say Wall Street, Mr. Whitney?
Madame, I took you with a little drink.
Oh, liquor has never crossed his lips.
You know a shortcut? Well, now that there are going to be 2 marriages, may I offer you the courtesy
of the ship for your return voyage
of your
honeymoon home?
Yeah!
You may join Dr. Moon while I must unfortunately turn over to the authority.
But Captain, we've had a radiogram from Washington. You're reading yourself.
Moonface Martin not wanted completely harmless with her to flee.
Let me see that. I have never been so insulted in my life. This is un-American.
As Confucius said, so long, you know how.
If that means what I think it does, yeah.
Where did you say you were staying in London, Mr. Whitney?
Here, Liz, wherever you are.
Well, Doctor,
you don't touch me, or I'll shoot. Bonnie! Bonnie!
What is it, Bonnie?
I'm not even public enemy number 13.